In this clip, I'd like to discuss the use of the word the, el, la, los, or las, with days of the week in Spanish. Okay. Now, if you do not yet know the 7 days of the week in Spanish, there's another clip that focuses just on teaching you those, how to spell them, how to pronounce them, how to remember them. So this one focuses with, hey, Mr. Holt, when do we need the in front of it? Here's the chant. Here's the takeaway I'd like you to have in 3 minutes. You need a word for the in front of days of the week, except after forms of ser. You need a word for the in front of days of the week, except after forms of ser. One last time, everybody, you need a word for the in front of days of the week, except after forms of ser. Now, I realize right now that sounds like gibberish, okay? Like I'm Charlie Brown's teacher going womp, 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 womp. But hopefully after we explore these 6 sentences, you'll understand what this is talking about, okay? And if not, you can watch the clip again. Number one, I have a date on Saturday. Yo tengo una cita el sábado. Yo tengo una cita el sábado. Number two, today is Saturday. Hoy es sábado. Hoy es sábado. Number three, I like Tuesdays. Me gustan los martes. Me gustan los martes. Number four, today is Tuesday. Hoy es martes. Hoy es martes. And number five, we take quizzes on Fridays. Tomamos pruebas los viernes. Tomamos pruebas los viernes. And finally, today is Friday. Hoy es viernes. Hoy es viernes. Now, a couple things to notice. Notice that we need a word for the in front of days of the week, except after forms of ser. Notice, in English we say, I have a date on Saturday. In Spanish they say, I have a date the Saturday. Well, why do they do that? Because think back, Spanish speakers love the word for the. In English we have one word for the, in Spanish they have four. So they stick it all over the place. One of the places they stick it is in front of days of the week. Think back to telling time. In English we say, it is 2 o'clock. In Spanish they say, son las dos, which literally means they are the two. Okay, so they just stick thus everywhere. So you always need a word for the in front of the days of the week. So let's look at number three. I like Tuesdays. Me gustan los martes. I like the Tuesdays. Okay, number five. We take quizzes on Fridays. Tomamos pruebas los viernes. Oh, I see, Mr. Holt. So do I always need a word for the in front of days of the week? No. Go back and look at the chant again. You need a word for the in front of days of the week, except after forms of ser. Anytime you're saying soy, eres, es, somos, or son, like today is Tuesday, tomorrow is Wednesday. Anytime you're saying is, you don't need a word for the. So, number two, today is Saturday. Hoy es sábado. Why isn't there a the? Because you're using a form of ser. Number four, today is Tuesday. Hoy es martes. Mr. Holt, why isn't there a the? Because remember, you're using a form of ser. So one more time. You need a word for the in front of days of the week, except after forms of ser. Usually the form of ser you're using is S, like today is, tomorrow is. All right, a couple other little points. Days of the week in Spanish are not capitalized. Notice, they're capitalized in English, but they're not capitalized in Spanish, all right? Spanish just capitalizes proper nouns and the very first word, or names actually, and the first word of a sentence. And finally, lunes, martes, miércoles, jueves, and viernes are both singular and plural. On Monday is el lunes, on Mondays is los lunes. Up here, I like Tuesdays. It's me gustan los martes, which looks like, to me, they are pleasing the Tuesday, but martes ends in es, and it's both singular and plural. Okay, also Friday, we take quizzes on Fridays. You don't say los vierneses, so because Monday through Friday already end in es, you never add es to them. All right, and I know that's a lot to throw at you, so you might want to watch this clip a second time. Hopefully it helped.